over-exaggeration to say that you had an issue with sex addiction?
First the depression, then a whole new problem. I'm Billy Bush, my Rick Springfield exclusive. The family life he had to struggle to save.
Will you stray again, do you?
Sex addiction isn't exactly how he describes it, but Rick Springfield admits it nearly ruined everything. It
didn't become an issue until I finally found somebody that I didn't want to lose.
Next. Depleted keg. Jesse's Girl made him famous and rich. Rick Springfield was 31 at the top of his game, both in music and on TV, landing the role of soap stud Dr. Noah Drake on General Hospital. But to the outside world, it seemed like Rick was leading the dream life. Reality, Rick was battling depression and had a problem with his sexual appetite, a problem that almost ruined his life.
You know, I had a huge house, money, beautiful wife, kid, touring the world, and realizing that that hadn't fixed me.
Depression hit Rick at an early age, puberty, and it followed him into his skyrocketing career. In his new memoir, Late, Late at Night, he gives his depression a name, Mr. D.
Is it an over-exaggeration to say that you had an issue with sex addiction, or is that...
I wouldn't say that's an over-exaggeration. I'd say it's part of the... my life, and I, this sex addiction is, I don't use that word in the book because it's not, to me, it's just my sexual issue. I wasn't addicted to sex as I was to the, it was a habit that I fell into as a young musician. It didn't become an issue until I finally found somebody that I didn't want to lose. Because of it, yeah.
That somebody's his wife of over 25 years, Barbara.
How close did you get to losing her?
Very close. I've become very close to losing her a couple of times. And the truth is, we both know that we're better together than we are apart. So we have fought the times that I have, fallen off the wagon. I nuked the wagon.
Rick's most recent Nuke the Wagon episode was Vegas, 2002.
How does she feel about what you're sharing?
Really?
Is she
uncomfortable?
Really? Was it a struggle between the two of you?
No, because I'm a writer, you know, and she married a guy who writes about his life. All my songs are about, most of my hits are about her, you know, honestly. Yeah. starting with Don't Talk to Strangers. A lot of my best songs have come from the dark side of me.
Baby, please, I can't please if I'm on my knees today.
Will you stray again, do you think? Do you fear
God,
you
hope
won't?
Not. I hope not. But, you know, it's like anything.
Will
you know,
she stick with you if you do?
No,
or will she
no,
say, get the hell out?
It's not a given.
Tomorrow on Access Hollywood, now number one, coast to coast.
Even here, I'm kind of a little nervous and fidgety,
I know,
you know.
Yeah.
And that's me.
I wonder why. Like, what makes you nervous now?
Depression, panic attacks, a life of anxiety despite fame and fortune. More exclusive revelations from Rick Springfield.
They're going to find out I'm just like a loser jerk eventually, so I got to dance as fast as I can.
That's tomorrow.
Needs.
Rick Springfield skyrocket to fame. I'm Maria Menounos with what he honestly thinks about Glee's rendition.
You know I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
Up Rick Springfield's rocket ride to stardom.
You know I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
Have you watched the Glee episode where they perform Jesse's girl?
Rick's reaction to being Gleeified.
With Rick Springfield.
It was a rocket ride for sure.
But fame and fortune brought depression. What makes Rick uncomfortable now?
I'm kind of a little nervous and fidgety,
I
know.
Is it an over-exaggeration to say that you had an issue with sex addiction, or is that...
I wasn't addicted to sex as I was to the... It was a habit that I fell into as a young musician.
And that habit almost cost him his family. Now in part two of my exclusive interview with Rick Springfield, Rick reveals how his struggle with depression almost ended his career and how he really is not comfortable in his own skin.
Oh, baby, stay, we got all night.
You're confident you come alive with a crowd. You don't get stage fright.
No, not at all. I don't. And, you know, even here, I'm kind of a little nervous and fidgety,
Yeah.
And that's me.
What makes you what makes you nervous now?
It's, you know, the part of the thing in the book that I call Mr. D, the depression. It's the guy always sticking me, you know, you're not good enough kind of thing. And I've always had to fight that.
So humble and yet haunted by depression since puberty, Rick Springfield became a superstar in the 1980s on stage and on TV as the handsome Dr. Noah Drake on the daytime soap General Hospital.
Bobby, you've been playing hard to get for so long. I have needs.
As Rick explains in his memoir, Late, Late at Night, he originally took the role of Dr. Drake to help pay the bills.
The acting paid off and the music paid off at the same time. That must have been the most mind-blowing moment of your life.
It was huge. I mean, it was a rocket ride for sure. And it was just something that you hang on, you know, you just hang on. It takes off with such force. You know I wish that I
had Jesse's girl. Rick's hit single, Jesse's Girl, was such a force, Glee did a tribute to it during season one, where Glee's Finn sings it in pursuit of Rachel. You know I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
I wish that I had Jesse's girl. Have you watched the Glee episode?
Yeah, my wife was watching. She said, you gotta come and see this.
What did you think?
I thought they did a great job.
Did they approach you when they used Jesse's Girl?
I found out later about it. I only own half the although I'm the writer of Jesse's Girl, I only own half the publishing, and that was a deal that was made way back, you know, when I was kind of clueless.
So they didn't need your okay?
So they didn't need my okay. Honestly, if they'd come to me, well, I was gonna say no, yeah. You know? Cause she's watching you with
those eyes. Not that he wrote it for the money, but when it comes to Jesse's Girl's overall residuals, Rick ain't complaining.
Did it buy you a house? Did it a second house?
It's bought me several houses, actually.